establish harmony. Now, the Japanese have two elderly people, it's called Takasawa. And there is the old woman who is sweeping away troubles. And then the old man has a rake, and he is raking in goods, benefit, and money. But this is not what, in the Chinese tradition, you will normally ever forward from. You must learn to balance. There is not unity. And there is this balance that is always maintained. Now, as a result, this is, in a sense, the ultimate relativity, that there can be nothing absolute except in theory, the circle. And if you see it as simply looking down, then even that is something in the region. Now, the concept of Shiva is, if any of you experience that in martial arts. Yes. Qi is something that science, Western science, can't really explain very well. For the Chinese, this is something they go up with and it becomes intuitive. When you go to the Great Wall of China and you see it, and you see the marvel that it is, what impresses you is the Qi coming from the wall, the energy. Now, this again is something that is alien to most people in this part of the world, but it is something that you're going to see more and more of. For example, if you go to Hawaii, you'll find that there are a number of practitioners of Qi, movements for slow movements, which try to get the body, as it were, in harmony, the yin and yang. Oh, I didn't mention this, but Chinese medicine, every organ is either yin or yang. And the Qi flows through the body. If it's blocked, then you have to unblock it, usually by acupuncture, needles. And this is the basis of health. Now, in the West, the idea of the harmony of the body is usually called homeostasis, this balance between things. And you cannot, at least in this world, overcome this balance, because the human body, unless there is a balance between opposites, ceases to exist. I'm not really familiar with any dialect, particularly about Mandarin dialect. That's what almost, and in Chinese they would call it Putin. In other words, the standard speech. This is an aside that you should know. The Chinese written language is the same throughout China. The spoken language is not. If you have film made in the North and shown in the South, it is shown with Chinese subtitles. The Cantonese of the South is utterly incomprehensible to the Mandarin of the North, and the Mandarin of the North incomprehensible to the Cantonese of the South. And that's simply the two main dialects. The only thing that has kept China together is the written language. The spoken language doesn't really hold the country together, it separates. Well, another way of seeing yin and yang is Newton's second law, where every action that is equal and opposite reacts. Again, Newton never came up with a symbol as captivating, shall we say, as that of yin and yang, but essentially the same idea.
mentioned the importance of this, of the written text. Is it true that the Mao's regime changed the characters to make them more proletarian?
Oh, yes.
If that's the case, wouldn't that be a major assault on the literary tradition because of the nuances of those characters?
Oh, yes. About 1,000 Chinese characters were simplified in the early 50s. The purpose was to make literacy more available. The result is some truly ugly thing. And again, this is the purpose. And under Mao, there was no question of this. The Little Red Book, when you have a country where surgeons, before they operate, read from Chairman Mao's Red Book, you don't question. You just don't question. And this has created a problem because the older texts in what is called traditional Chinese are becoming much more difficult for the young Chinese to read. And there are parts of the Chinese world where they keep the traditional characters, for example, Hong Kong, and now integrating into China, they must adopt the simplified characters. The best way to get a feel of that, if you have a DVDs of subtitles, you find simplified Chinese, traditional Chinese. And what it is essentially is limiting the number of strokes. Fewer strokes. It's almost a form of abbreviation. But again, much of the beauty and the history of the word is lost.
Well, thank you once again.